Kilkenny, Carlow, KCLR.
I'm just really excited for the game itself. I know it was last year there was such hype around it because we hadn't won in so long, but I think this year now we can just focus on ourselves and just look forward to the game itself.
You're the captain this year?
Yeah.
Does that bring added sort of nerves to it, or do you just put it at the back of your head?
Yeah, there's a lot of picture taking and talking and all that, but once the week of the match starts now, that's all I'll be thinking of and nothing else really. But that's what you have to do. You have to put everything else to the back of your mind and just think of what's ahead of you on the big day.
The goal, obviously, at the start of the year is the same as any year, is to do your best but get to the All-Ireland Final again. Dublin, he's played in the semi-final as well. Dublin, of course, still up and coming relatively. They're under the stewardship now of David Herty, who's doing a great job with them as well. But he's won the game, I suppose, not comfortably in the end, but it was always assured, I think, from our point of view anyway. Would you have expected, or would you have preferred a bigger test, I suppose, in the semi-final, or does that make a difference?
I think you kind of have to approach any game that's ahead of you. Like, we knew Dublin were going to be give us a good hard game, and we needed it before we went in. You know, a lot of people said because we'd beaten them in the other championship that, you know, we'd walked the game, but that was completely, we didn't believe that at all. We knew Dublin were going to come at us, and they were on such a roll because it was their first time being there in, you know, so long. So they were, all they wanted to do was play. They had nothing to fear. They threw everything at us, and when you play a team like that, you really have to dig deep and you really have to see who wants it more. You know, like, sometimes things aren't going to work out and, you know, things aren't going to come off, but when you have a bit of heart and determination like we did, I think closing off that game, that's the main thing really.
A couple of injuries this year to contend with as well, but all you can do is get on with who you have as well, but you have young girls coming in there as well, and the team has to, you do the job on the day regardless of who you have.
Exactly. Now, we have a brilliant background team with ourselves. We have Nicola Edward there, and we have Dr. Martin, Dr. Fergus. We have so many people there helping us. Lee Meegan does our strength and conditioning. So I know we have a good few injuries, but that's why we have such a huge group to pick from. There's so many young ones after coming in this year. I think Danielle Morrissey's after starting the last two games, and a few other girls after coming in as well. So you need to see everyone so that you know what to have for the big day then. If people do unfortunately get injured, it is going to happen. So anyone that's there to be picked anyway will play and play.
Cork again this year. He's had a crack at them already this year so far as well, but how do you view them, I suppose, going in this year? They've been very strong this year, and they're gunning for that All-Ireland final. They were bitter last year.
Exactly, yeah. They have such hunger now from last year after losing last year, but they have a great team and we do ourselves, but we played them in the league, and I think the both of us have completely different teams since then, so I think the championship now, it'll be a lot different. I think Cork have a great team, and even last year going into the match, sure, we knew they had a brilliant team and they've done so much, had won so much before us there, and we were lucky to win the All-Ireland last year to beat them, a great team. So we're just going to have to go in with the same determination and the heart that we had last year, and I think Cork have a great team.
A hugely experienced coach in the shape of Anne, and of course you have a great backroom team in the club as well. How is she preparing us, I suppose, mentally for going into this game? Like, last year was a huge mountain because it hadn't been done in 20 odd years, and now you're trying to back up an All-Ireland final against the same team.
Exactly, yeah. We knew we'd have to work even harder this year compared to last year, and I think last year everyone stepped it up, and this year has been stepped up even more. I think the training has been brilliant this year, and the management and the background team that we have, the people we have, we can go to anyone who have any problems, even if it's not related to camogie. So it's brilliant to have that, the management and the doctors we have in the background. It's great to have the strength and conditioning as well, and camogie has come on so much now with strength and conditioning, so I think that's a main acid that's been brought onto our team this year.
What's it like at home in a run-up to an All-Ireland? What's the family like? I suppose the support is obviously great, and down in Thomastown as well. But what's your plan for All-Ireland final day, or the days coming up to it as well? Is everyone to leave us alone, or what's the story?
I know we'll have our mum and dad in our ear the whole time anyway, giving us tips, but it's brilliant at home the way the three of us are playing together, so it's great, and we can talk about it a lot. We give each other advice, or if anyone needs to work on something, we wouldn't be too shy to tell them what to say anyway, but no, it's great to have the two girls at home, and then sure, John Joe can give us a bit of advice if we need it, and Mam and Dad are brilliant as well that way.
What's the support like down in Thomastown?
Yeah, it's brilliant. Everyone gets behind you. And because we did so well with the club last year at Camogie, I think that it's gone, everyone in the town is looking at Camogie a lot more now, so it's brilliant. And you'd be walking down the street and everyone would be wishing you the best of luck, so it's great. There's a great atmosphere in Thomastown and everyone's mad into it there.
What message have you got for supporters before the game in a couple of weeks?
For the supporters? I would please God that there'll be a good few there anyway. You know, when you have people behind you, like we've had so much in Kilkenny this year, it drives you on even more. And it's like they say, it's like a 16 player on the team when you hear people cheering you on when you are under pressure. So hopefully we'll have a good crowd this year. It's been so well promoted in Camogie with the association. And I know this year the county board and the Camogie station have actually organised a ticket for, I think it's €35 for the under 21 and for the senior Camogie, so you know that might encourage some families to get to it as well.
Yeah, the under 21 matches earlier in the day compared to usual, so it gives people doing two matches a chance of a break in the evening and then go to the Camogie the next day.
Exactly, yeah, and that again shows how far Camogie has come, because that wouldn't have happened in previous years. You know, people wouldn't have even known the Camogie match was on. So now that they're trying to promote it so much, and with the ticket and all of that as well, to like the hurlers and the Camogie players on the one ticket, it just shows that Kilkenny's after getting behind the Camogie as well, which is brilliant for us.
Kilkenny, Carlow, KCLR.